Warm greetings to everyone. I hope everyone is keeping safe and fine. Did you know that a snail can sleep for 3 years? Humans are the only species known to blush. There are so many unbelievable things in the world we don't know about. Why not learn a little more and broaden our knowledge? So, to provide an ambience that will promote limitless imagination and enable the school students to kindle their interest in science, here we are, the Shivajians of second year from Department of Chemistry. Every year we conduct a science awareness program for school students to develop interest in science, to make it fun with experiments, to give them the opportunity to make a positive role model in their life. And so, here we are. So, without any delay, let's start with it. For making it more interesting, interactive, and to promote scientific temper, here we have brought Science Awareness Quiz, which you can give on any available devices that are at your home. That could be your mobile or your laptop. Certificate will be issued on the submission of the quiz. Firstly, watch the entire video so that you can answer well in the quiz. Then to participate in the quiz, you need to click on the link which is attached below in the message. Firstly, provide some very basic information and then answer the quiz. All the questions are required. At the submission of the quiz, you will receive a certificate on Gmail which you provided earlier. I humbly invite Dr. Anjali Bodhade, Joint Secretary of the event, to give us a welcome speech.
Warm greetings to respected teachers and my dear students. I hope you all are keeping safe and fine. On behalf of the Department of Chemistry, Sri Shivaji Science College, Amravati, wishing you Happy Science Day celebration. It's my great pleasure to welcome Principal Dr. B.G. Thackeray sir as the chairman of this event. Dr. G.N. Chaudhary, professor and head of the department, as a convener. All the departmental staff members, all the school teachers, and my dear students. I, Dr. Anjali Bodhade, the organizing secretary of this event, extend a warm welcome for National Science Day celebration. On the eve of National Science Day celebration, we have organized demonstration of scientific concepts to the school children by our BSc second year students. It was a task given to them for the preparation of syllabus-oriented videos. It took 3 months span to complete this activity. At the end, we received 40 videos, out of which we have shortlisted best 13 videos for presentation before you. Students, I hope you'll be benefited by these videos for your future endeavor. I kindly request you to watch the videos carefully and solve the quiz with interest. Thank you. Happy watching.
Now, I would like to invite Dr. G.N. Chaudhary for his introductory remark.
Characharat Vaskarnari Gurudev Shakti, Dr. Bhausaheb Panjabrao Deshmukh, Yancha Smrutis Vinamra Abhivadan Karto, Ya Karyakramacha Adhyaksha, Pracharya Dr. Vigo Thackeray Sir, Coordinator Dr. Anjali Bodhade, Maje Sarva Sahakari आणि विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, रसायनशास्त्र विभाग श्री शिवाजी विज्ञान महाविद्यालय अमरावतीच्या वतीने विज्ञान प्रसार कार्यक्रमासाठी मी विभाग प्रमुख डॉ. गजानन चौधरी आपले सर्वांचे स्वागत करतो. आनंदाची बाब म्हणजे हा ऑनलाईन उपक्रम आमच्या बीएससी भाग 2 च्या विद्यार्थ्यांच्या वतीने आयोजित केला असून हे विद्यार्थी डेमॉन्स्ट्रेशनच्या माध्यमातून शालेय विद्यार्थ्यांसाठी हा वैज्ञानिक उपक्रम राबवित आहेत. शालेय विद्यार्थ्यांना सहज व सुलभतेने विज्ञानाचे आकलन व्हावे हा या कार्यक्रमाचा हेतू आहे. तर या विज्ञानवादी विद्यार्थ्यांनी आयोजित या कार्यक्रमाचा लाभ आमच्या सर्व शालेय विद्यार्थ्यांनी घ्यावा ही विनंती. धन्यवाद.
आय वुड लाईक टू रिक्वेस्ट प्रिन्सिपल डॉक्टर व्ही जी ठाकरे टू एनलाइटन अस विथ हिज वर्ड्स ऑफ विजडम.
शिक्षण महर्षी डॉक्टर भाऊसाहेब पंजाबराव देशमुख यांच्या पावन स्मृतीचं अभिवादन करतो. सर्वप्रथम महाविद्यालयाचा प्राचार्य या नात्याने मी आपणा सर्वांचे विज्ञान प्रसार कार्यक्रमासाठी स्वागत करतो. आपण सर्वजण जाणताच की गेल्या मार्च महिन्यापासून COVID-19 प्रभावामुळे आपण सर्व समाजव्यवस्था आणि शिक्षण व्यवस्थेत अनेक प्रकारच्या बदलांना सामोरे जातो आहोत. त्याचाच एक भाग म्हणून ऑनलाईन शिक्षण प्रणाली एक वर आलेली आहे, एक वरदान ठरली आहे. त्यानुसार शिवाजी विज्ञान महाविद्यालय अमरावतीच्या रसायनशास्त्र विभागाच्या वतीने एक अतिशय स्तुत्य असा ऑनलाईन उपक्रम राबविण्यात येत आहे. यामध्ये प्राध्यापकांच्या मार्गदर्शनात महाविद्यालयीन विद्यार्थ्यांनी 8वी व 9वीच्या विद्यार्थ्यांपर्यंत त्यांच्याच अभ्यासक्रमातील वैज्ञानिक प्रयोग व संकल्पना ऑनलाईन मार्गदर्शनातून प्रयोगाद्वारे पोचवण्याचा एक उपक्रम हाती घेतलेला आहे. या संकल्पना पोचवल्या जाणार आहेत. या उपक्रमाचा लाभ शिवाजी शिक्षण संस्थेअंतर्गत येणाऱ्या सर्व शाळांना होणार आहे. गेल्या वर्षीच याच विज्ञान प्रसार कार्यक्रमाअंतर्गत आपण शिवाजी शिक्षण संस्थेच्या वतीने सायन्स इनोव्हेशन अँड ॲक्टिव्हिटी सेंटर हे या विभागातील विद्यार्थ्यांसाठी उपलब्ध करून दिलेलं आहे. पण दुर्दैवाने कोविडच्या प्रादुर्भावामुळे अजून ते विद्यार्थ्यांकरता खुलं करता आलं नाही. तेही सुद्धा या येणाऱ्या काळात विद्यार्थ्यांकरता खुलं होणार आहे. या उपक्रमामुळे मला असं वाटते की स्वर्गीय भाऊसाहेब देशमुख यांना अभिप्रेत असलेली महाविद्यालयाने शालेय विद्यार्थ्यांसाठी राबवलेले हे कार्य म्हणजे खऱ्या अर्थाने श्रद्धांजली असेल एवढंच मी या प्रसंगी सांगू इच्छितो. आणि या उपक्रमाकरता महाविद्यालयातील ज्यांनी श्रम घेतले, या विभागाचे विभागप्रमुख डॉक्टर जी एन चौधरी, डॉक्टर अंजली बोदडे, डॉक्टर निलेश ठाकरे व विभागातील सर्व रसायनशास्त्राचे प्राध्यापक यांचं मी महाविद्यालयाच्या प्राचार्य या नात्याने सर्वांचं अभिनंदन करतो आणि या प्रसार विज्ञान प्रसार कार्यक्रमाकरता शुभेच्छा देतो. धन्यवाद.
थँक्यू व्हेरी मच सर. इन दिस इव्हेंट वी रिसीव्ड 40 व्हिडिओज from which 13 of them were shortlisted. The topics covered are study of hydrocarbons by Mr. Abhishek Sherke, polar satellite launch vehicle by Mr. Shubham Jadhav, periodic trends by Kumari Misbah Patel, revolution of earth seasons by Kumari Vaishnavi Lonkar, Newton's laws of motion by Ms. Rucha Dhakore, scalar versus vector quantity by Mr. Anand Umare, Stress Management by Ms. Dipti Thakre, Types of Bond by Mr. Shitij Patkar, Ecosystem by Ms. Anaga Rathod, Solutions for Global Warming by Ms. Pallavi Chandure, Photometry by Ms. Rudrani Bharavde, Biotechnology by Mr. Arpit Kare, Conical Pendulum by Sanskruti Khandare. I hope you'll enjoy the concepts explained by our students. The stage is all yours.
Hi everyone, my name is Abhishek Shirke and I am from Sri Shivaji Science College, Amravati. Today we will learn about hydrocarbons briefly. As we seen the amazing properties of carbon atom to form bonds with various other elements and also with the other carbon atoms. But the most preferred element for combination is hydrogen. Carbon and hydrogen readily combines to form a vast range of compounds. These compounds are called as hydrocarbons. Also, the compound containing hydrogen and carbon are called as hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons are further classified into two categories, saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons. Saturated hydrocarbons are those hydrocarbons in which the carbon atom is linked to the another carbon atom by single bond. And unsaturated hydrocarbons are those hydrocarbons in which the carbon atoms are linked to each other by double or triple bond. In saturated hydrocarbons, example is alkene, while in unsaturated hydrocarbons, the examples are alkene and alkyne. They are further classified into three categories on the basis of molecular structure. straight chain hydrocarbon, branch chain hydrocarbon and cyclic hydrocarbons, whereas unsaturated hydrocarbons are further classified into three categories on the basis of molecular structure: straight chain hydrocarbon, branch chain hydrocarbon and cyclic hydrocarbons.
My name is Shubham Tarachandra. Friends, my topic is the structure of an PSLV made by an ISRO.
Dear student, this is the PSLV satellite I made by my hand by using censure paper.
PSLV is made by an ISRO. The uppermost part of the satellite is a satellite separation system. हे अंतरात गेल्यावरच त्याचे दोन पार्ट होतात आणि तिथून रिमूव्ह होतो. हे मेन म्हणजे सॅटेलाइट ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टीम जो सेकंड पार्ट आहे आणि हा रेड कलरचा जो फर्स्ट पार्ट आहे त्याला थर्ड स्टेप जनरेशन म्हणतात. आणि ही जी वेट मेन व्हाईट जी पीएसएलव्ही नाव इंडिया लिहून आहे ही आहे सेकंड ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टीम. आणि ही जे सर्वात खाली आहे आणि सर्वात बॉटमला राहते त्याला म्हणतात फर्स्ट स्टेप ऑफ सेपरेशन. आणि त्या साईडला थोड्या लहान लहान प्रकारचे रॉकेट्स म्हणता येईल. आपण दिवाळीतही पाहतो. ही जे मी तुम्हाला आता ओरली सांगितलेलं आहे ते तुम्हाला समजणार नसेल तर मी एक व्हिडिओ पण तयार केला आहे याच्यावर. सध्याचा काळ तुम्हाला माहित आहे हा कोरोनाचा काळ आहे. त्याच्यामुळे तुम्ही घरीच राहा, सुरक्षित राहा, सॅनिटायझर आणि मास्कचा भरपूर वापर करा.
हॅलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज मिसबा पाटील. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सम स्पेशल ट्रेंड्स ऑफ द एलिमेंट इन पीरियॉडिक टेबल. यू कॅन सी इन पीरियॉडिक टेबल वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ द एलिमेंट सच एज मेटल, मेटलाइट एंड नॉन मेटल्स आर अरेंज इन द पीरियड्स एंड द ग्रुप. दिस हॉरिझॉन्टल रोज आर कॉल्ड एज द पीरियड्स एंड दिस वर्टिकल रोज इज कॉल्ड एज द ग्रुप. सो फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द एटॉमिक रेडियस. As we notice the period from left to right, we see that every new electron is added in the same shell of that element, due to which the size of the element is decreases from left to right in a period, and hence atomic radius of the element decreases in a period from left to right. When it groups, every upcoming element is added in the new shell, and hence the size of the element is increases in a group from top to bottom, and hence atomic radius is increases in a group. So these are some properties of the element. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Vaishnavi Lodhan. Welcome to this science awareness program where we learn different fun fact which is happening on this earth. So today I will be teaching you the revolution of earth around the sun and the seasons. Maximum time what happened, we can't imagine the actual position and the actual situation of the earth while revolving around the sun. So today I will give the practical demonstration of the revolution of earth around the sun. So for the practical demonstration I have used some props, like this is the sun and this is the earth. So our earth rotate in this position like this, from west to east. So you can clearly see that the maximum sunlight is falling on the Tropic of Cancer. The maximum sunlight is falling on the northern part of the earth now, and this position of earth is called as summer solstice, and reverse position in the southern hemisphere, where the southern hemisphere is experiencing the winter. And now earth revolved in this position. So now earth has come to this position, and this position of earth is called as the equinox, that is first equinox, where all world is experiencing the equal days and equal lights. Now earth goes in this position to here. So you can clearly see that at this position the maximum sunlight is falling on the southern part of the earth. This position of earth is called as winter solstice. Now from here earth goes on this position, and this position of earth is called as second equinox, and these are the four position of earth while revolving around the sun.
Good morning. My name is Ruchananda Dapore, student of Sri Shivaji Science College, and under the Science Awareness Program today I'll be teaching you Newton's Laws of Motion. But before that, let me give you a brief introduction about Sir Isaac Newton. Sir Isaac Newton was one of the greatest influential scientists of all time. And his three laws of motion laid the foundation of mechanics. So let's get started. So, Newton's first law of motion states that an object will continue to be at rest or in uniform motion along a straight line until and unless some kind of external unbalanced force acts on it. It is also known as law of inertia. Inertia is the tendency of a body to maintain its previous state or tendency of a body to resist motion. So here I have an experiment to demonstrate first law. So here it's a glass over which there is a cardboard and over which there is a coin. So when I flick the cardboard, coin fell into the glass, which shows us that as force was not applied on the coin, it fell in the glass, and cardboard over which force was applied just flipped out. So let's move on to the second law of motion, which states that rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to the unbalanced force, and the change of momentum occurs in the direction of force. Now let's move on to the third law of motion, which states that for every action there is equal and opposite reaction which acts simultaneously. Third law is responsible for birds to fly in air, and this action-reaction combo helps birds to stay in air and fly. The same thing happens with the rocket also.
Welcome to Science Awareness Program. I am Anand Umale from Sri Shivaji Science College, Amravati. We are conducting this program to aware the student about the magical world of science. So, my topic is scalar versus vector quantity. So, the first difference is about the definitions of the scalar quantity and the vector quantity. So, what is meant by the scalar quantity? The physical quantities which have only magnitude is called as the scalar quantity, and the vector quantity, the physical quantities which have magnitude as well as direction, is called as the vector quantity. The physical quantity means the measurable quantity. Example, suppose I am buying 5 kg sugar, then 5 kg indicate the mass of the sugar. Therefore, it is scalar quantity. And suppose my body weight is the vector quantity, because the normal force is directed opposite to the gravitational force. Therefore, it is the relation between the mass and the direction. Therefore, it is the vector quantity. Vector quantity is one-dimensional quantity, and vector quantity is multidimensional quantity. We are getting this point by the example. Suppose speed of car is 35 km per hour, then 35 km per hour is one-dimensional quantity. That indicates that the speed is the scalar quantity, and velocity is 35 km per hour at ease. That means 35 km per hour is related with the direction, that is two-dimensional quantity.
Hello friends, my name is Arpit Kale, and today I am here to deliver my seminar, and my seminar topic is biotechnology. These are the following contents of my seminar. First one is the introduction of biotechnology. It includes what is biotechnology, history of biotechnology, define biotechnology. Second is the types of biotechnology, then applications of biotechnology, aim of biotechnology, conclusion, and last is the references of the biotechnology. So we proceed to the first point, that is the introduction of biotechnology. What is biotechnology? As simple as, biotechnology is the technology based on biology. Biotechnology coupled with a cellular and a biomolecular process to develop technologies and a product that helps to improve our lives and the health. History of biotechnology. Humans have used biotechnology since the dawn of the civilization and the Neolithic revolution. Hungarian agriculture engineer Károly Erki first coined the term biotechnology in 1919. Define biotechnology. Biotechnology is the branch of science that utilizes living organisms and their derivatives in order to produce product that is useful for the mankind. Now we discuss about the types of biotechnology. Biotechnology is broadly classified into four major types. First one is the red biotechnology, blue biotechnology, white biotechnology, and green biotechnology. Red biotechnology is concerned with the health sector, vaccines, antibodies, developing new drug, molecular diagnostic techniques, regenerative therapies, and the development of the genetic engineering to cure diseases. In current situation, to tackle the problems of novel coronavirus, we completely depend on the red biotechnologies. Blue biotechnologies is concerned with aquatic life, coastal plains, and the exploitation of the marine resources to create products and applications of the industrial interest. White biotechnology is concerned with the industrial sector, including industrial fermentation, component of cell like enzymes, microorganisms to create products such as chemical, food, soap, detergent, paper, textiles and biofuels as well. Green biotechnology is concerned with the agriculture sector. The genetically modified crop, GM crop and BT crop are used in agriculture. DNA has been modified by using genetic engineering. The main aim to introduce new trait that does not occur naturally in species. Now we discuss about the applications of the biotechnology. Biotechnology has applications in four major industrial sectors. It including healthcare, the crop production and agriculture, the non-food use of crop and their product, and the environmental uses. For example, the one applications of biotechnology is directed use of the microorganism for the manufacture of organic product, just like beer and a milk product. Another example is using the naturally present bacteria by the mining industries of the bioleaching. Biotechnology is also used to recycle, treat waste and clean site contaminated by the industrial activities by the process called as bioremediation, and also used to produce biological weapons. Biotechnology industries has changed a lot during last decade, which means moving ahead from traditional way to more advanced technological development. Now we move toward the last point, that is the references. My first reference is the Wikipedia. I acquire more information from Wikipedia and 12th standard biology NCERT book as well. Thank you so much for listening to me so patiently. Have a nice day.
Hello everyone, welcome to Science Awareness Program. I am Kumari Sanskruti Kiran Khandare from Sri Shivaji Science College, Amravati. I am pursuing Bachelor's of Science degree in PSIM group. I am here with the topic conical pendulum and its expression. So first of all, what is the conical pendulum? It's a simple structure or a simple pendulum which gives such a motion that the bob describes a circle and the string describes a cone. Here I have something to demonstrate you. Here I have a string to which I have attached a bob. I am rotating it in a circular motion. So what did we find here? If it tries to diagramize it, it will be like in such a way that it is making the angle theta over here. If we talk about the circular plane, the circle is making the radius r. Suppose the length of the string is l. If we talk about the free body diagram, that bob possesses some mass which is equal to mg. The string faces some tension which is T. I am drawing a line over here which is perpendicular to a vertical line. The one component of the T, that is T cos theta. Here is R, another component of T, that is T sin theta. We know that the object is rotating in the horizontal circle and there is no vertical motion. And if there is no vertical motion, then the forces are balanced. Means the total upward force is equal to the total downward force. Hence, we get our one first equation here, that is T cos theta is equal to mg. We know that the bob is rotating in the horizontal circle, which means that the resultant force is directed towards the center, and the force which is directed towards center is called as the centripetal force. The formula for the centripetal force is mv square upon r. So we get another equation, that is T sin theta is equal to centripetal force, that is equal to mv square upon r. This is our equation 1. I am writing the another equation above the first equation, that is T sin theta is equal to mv square upon r. If we divide these two equations, we get this T and this T will get cancelled. Sin theta upon cos theta, we get tan theta. This m and this m will get cancelled and we will get mv square upon rg. Just shifting this v square here, we get v square is equal to rg tan theta. This is our formula to calculate the velocity of the conical pendulum. But our motive is to find the time period of conical pendulum. So, we know that the relation between the velocity and the angular speed is equal to v is equal to r omega. So, we will replace this v with the r omega. Here is the v square, so we will write it as r square omega square is equal to rg tan theta. This r and this r will get cancelled. omega square r is equals to g tan theta. Let's see that r here. Omega square is equals to g tan theta upon r. If we cancel that, this square we get omega is equals to under root g tan theta upon r. This is our formula to find the angular speed. So, omega is equals to 2 pi by t. If we take this t at the left side, we get t is equals to 2 pi by omega. We have already find out the value for omega, that is 2 under root of g tan theta by r. I am just substituting that value. T is equals to 2 pi under root g tan theta by r. If we take this 2 pi outside, we get t is equals to 2 pi under root. This r will come at the numerator place and the g tan theta will come at the denominator. Here is the formula from which we can calculate the time period of the conical pendulum, but it's in the form of r. But when the question will be asked to you, it will be in the form of l. So we will convert this r into l. We know that here I have drawn the small diagram, but you can see detailed over here. Just to convert this r into l, we know that here is the right, here we are forming a right angle. So according to the law of geometry, you should know that the sine theta is equals to hypotenuse, opposite upon hypotenuse. So here the opposite is r and the hypotenuse is our l. We get r is equal sine theta is equals to r by l. We need to find the equation in the form of l. So we will take this r in the left hand side to get r is equals to l sine theta. Let's substitute r is equals to l sine theta here. T is equals to 2 pi under root l sine theta upon g tan theta. If you know tan theta is equals to sine theta upon cos theta, t is equals to 2 pi under root l sine theta. I am just writing this tan theta as sine theta upon cos theta, that is g sine theta divided by cos theta. Here this sine theta and sine theta will get cancelled. We get the formula t is equals to 2 pi under root l cos theta upon g. Here we get the exact formula to calculate the time period of the conical pendulum. But here we face one exception, that is if theta is too low or tends to 0, means theta is too low or tends to 0. If you know some rules of trigonometry, you will know that cos 0 is equals to 1. And if the theta tends to 0, that is cos 0 is equals to 1, we get t is equals to 2 pi under root l cos 0 is 1 upon g. This is the formula to find out the time period of the simple pendulum. This one is for the conical pendulum. I would suggest that one should memorize this formula as it is really very important. So that's it. Hope you learned something from my video.
Hello friends, welcome to the Science Awareness Program. Myself Dipti Thakri from Sri Shivaji Science College. Today I am going to talk on stress management. Stress can be managed by some ways. First, talk about your problem. Go and share with your friends and family about your feelings so that you will get confident. Second, set realistic expectations. Keep your goals smart. Don't expect too much things from your life. Third, say no to some things. Dance. As everyone enjoys dancing while talking on the phone
doing laundry or cleaning process, you can dance. Second, laugh. This will reduce your anxiety, relieve stress by stimulating your organs. Third, connect with others. Go into the garden, spend time with your friends, animals also, like dog and cat, it will make you feel enjoy. Being in the nature always increases energy levels and reduce depression and boost well-being. Sixth way is the meditation. It reduces stress while improving sleep and cognitive function. This is how we can manage the stress. So, as the stress is the epidemic of 21st century, being happy is the remedy for this. Thank you so much.
I am Shiti Devkiran Patkar from Sri Shivaji Science College, Amravati. What is bond? A chemical bond is an attractive force between atoms that connects them together. बॉन्ड म्हणजे दोन ॲटम्स मधील जो अट्रॅक्टिव्ह फोर्स असतो ज्यामुळे ते एकत्र येतात त्याला आपण केमिकल बॉन्ड असे म्हणू शकतो. आता उदाहरण द्यायचं झालं तर दोन मित्रांमधील जो संबंध असतो त्याला आपण मैत्रीचा बॉन्ड असे म्हणू शकतो. त्याचप्रकारे दोन ॲटम मधील जो अट्रॅक्टिव्ह फोर्स मध्ये एकत्र येतात त्यालाच आपण केमिकल बॉन्ड असे म्हणतो. हा अट्रॅक्टिव्ह फोर्स कशामुळे त्या ॲटम्स मध्ये निर्माण होतो? जर ॲटम मध्ये एखाद दोन इलेक्ट्रॉनची जर कमतरता असेल तर हा अट्रॅक्टिव्ह फोर्स निर्माण होतो. बॉन्ड्स आर फॉर्म बिटवीन ॲटम्स टू बिकम स्टेबल. टाइप्स ऑफ बॉन्ड तीन प्रकारचे आहेत. पहिला बॉन्ड कोवॅलंट बॉन्ड, दुसरा आयनिक बॉन्ड, तिसरा मेटॅलिक बॉन्ड. बघूया कोवॅलंट बॉन्ड म्हणजे काय. अ बॉन्ड विच इज फॉर्म बाय म्युच्युअल शेअरिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इज कॉल्ड ॲज कोवॅलंट बॉन्ड. कोवॅलंट बॉन्ड म्हणजे असा बॉन्ड ज्यामध्ये दोन्ही ॲटम सारख्या प्रमाणात आपले इलेक्ट्रॉन शेअर करून जो बॉन्ड बनवतात त्यालाच कोवॅलंट बॉन्ड म्हणतात. आता आपण बघूया आयनिक बॉन्ड म्हणजे काय. द इलेक्ट्रोस्टॅटिक अट्रॅक्शन बिटवीन पॉझिटिव्ह अँड निगेटिव्ह आयन इज कॉल्ड ॲज आयनिक बॉन्ड. आणि त्याच आयनिक बॉन्डला इलेक्ट्रोवॅलंट बॉन्ड सुद्धा म्हटल्या जाते. इट इज फॉर्म बाय ट्रान्सफर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्रॉम वन ॲटम टू अनदर ॲटम. इट फॉर्म्स बिटवीन मेटल अँड नॉन मेटल. आणि नेहमी आयनिक बॉन्ड हे मेटल अँड नॉन मेटल मध्येच फॉर्म होतो. फॉर एक्झाम्पल इथे दिलेलं आहे NaCl, KCl. द अट्रॅक्टिव्ह इंटरॅक्शन बिटवीन कॅटायन्स अँड मोबाईल इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इज कॉल्ड ॲज मेटॅलिक बॉन्ड. अट्रॅक्टिव्ह इंटरॅक्शन बिटवीन कॅटायन्स. कॅटायन्स म्हणजे पॉझिटिव्ह चार्ज आयन्स. इट होल्ड्स ऑल ॲटम्स टुगेदर इन मेटल क्रिस्टल. इट फॉर्म्स बिटवीन मेटल अँड मेटल. आणि हे मेटॅलिक बॉन्ड हा नेहमी दोन मेटलमध्येच घडून येतो. अशा प्रकारे आपल्याला समजून आलं असेल की टाइप्स ऑफ बॉन्ड किती आहेत व कशा प्रकारे आहेत.
हॅलो फ्रेंड्स, आय एम नवरा राठोड. टुडे वी आर हियर टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक ऑफ इकोसिस्टम. एज वी नो, ऑल द लिव्हिंग थिंग्स इन आवर नेचर अँड ऑल्सो द नॉन लिव्हिंग थिंग्स आर द पार्ट ऑफ द इकोसिस्टम. ऑल द लिव्हिंग थिंग्स सच एज प्लांट्स, एनिमल्स अँड ऑर्गॅनिझम्स इन द गिवन एरिया इंटरॅक्ट विथ इच अदर ऑल्सो विथ द नॉन लिव्हिंग एन्व्हायरमेंट. फॉर एक्झाम्पल एअर, सॉइल, सनलाईट. इकोसिस्टम कन्सिस्ट ऑफ टू कंपोनंट्स, अ बायोटिक कंपोनंट अँड बायोटिक कंपोनंट. It consists of two factors, physical factor and chemical factor. Physical factor is a factor in the abiotic environment that influences the growth and the development of the biological community. For example, air, water, soil and sunlight. Chemical factors are the biodegradable constituents. For example, nutrients and minerals. Now we will see about biotic components. Biotic components consist of two parts. Autotrophic and heterotrophic. Autotrophic use the inorganic substances to synthesize their food. Producers is the part of autotrophic. It carry out the photosynthesis constituent to synthesize their food. Heterotrophic use the intake and digestion organic systems for synthesizing their food. It has two parts, consumers and decomposers. All the animals are consumers. They are of three parts, primary consumers, secondary consumers and tertiary consumers. This was the components of ecosystem. I hope friends you got my point what I wanted to say. Thank you.
Myself Pallavi Saran Sandhuri. The solution for the global warming. First one, planting more trees. Second, reducing waste generation. Third, reducing the use of production which generate greenhouse gases. Fourth, using energy efficient appliances. Fifth, increasing the fuel efficiency of vehicles. Sixth, using more renewable energy. when this is all about greenhouse effect and global warming.
Hello friends, I am Rudrani Krishnakant Barabde. Today we are going to study a very new and interesting topic, that is photometry. Let's start from introduction. So friends, what is photometry?
Friends, photometry is a combination of two words, that is photo and metry. Photo means the light particles and metry means the technique of measurement. And the device used to measure the intensity of light is known as photometer. So friends, apne analyte solution ghetla hai. First of all, we should know what is meant by analyte solution. Analyte solution means asa solution jasa aplyala analysis karaycha hai. So apan ek analyte solution ghetla hai ani the analyte solution madhun apan ek specific intensity cha light beam pass kela. Tar ata te solution kay karel? त्याच्या कपॅसिटीनुसार एक स्पेसिफिक इंटेन्सिटीचा लाईट आपल्याला स्वतः ऍब्झॉर्ब करेल अँड द रिमेनिंग लाईट विल बी रिफ्लेक्टेड अँड दिस रिफ्लेक्टेड लाईट इज मेजर्ड विथ द हेल्प ऑफ फोटोमीटर. लेट्स सी द टाइप्स ऑफ फोटोमेट्री. फ्रेंड्स, देअर आर व्हेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ फोटोमेट्री बट हिअर वी विल डिस्कस ओनली टू, दॅट इज स्पेक्ट्रोफोटोमेट्री अँड फ्लेम फोटोमेट्री. दॅट इज स्पेक्ट्रोफोटोमेट्री. फ्रेंड्स, या टेक्निकचा वापर एखाद्या अनालाइट सोल्युशननी किती इंटेन्सिटीचा लाईट स्वतः ऍब्झॉर्ब केला आहे हे मेजर करण्यासाठी होतो. अँड द इन्स्ट्रुमेंट युज फॉर दिस टेक्निक इज नोन ऍज स्पेक्ट्रोफोटोमीटर. अँड द इन्स्ट्रुमेंट युज फॉर दिस टेक्निक इज नोन ऍज फ्लेम फोटोमीटर. द पिक्चर ऑफ फ्लेम फोटोमीटर. सो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज द बेसिक कन्सेप्ट ऑफ फोटोमेट्री. आय होप यू गॉट माय ऑल पॉइंट्स.
I hope you understood the basic concepts and enjoyed learning with our students and will be surely benefited. Our aim is always to enrich the scientific passion of the students, and every year we do that by visiting a school and spend whole day nurturing the students. But this year we had to do it in a different manner. And so we came up with an idea of making a video for this purpose, so that all students could get the opportunity. And so, hoping that we have achieved of what we desired. My tributes to Dr. Bhausaheb Panjabrao Deshmukh, the founder president of Sri Shivaji Education Society, Amravati. I would like to thank Sri Harshavardhan Ji Deshmukh, President of Sri Shivaji Education Society Amravati, for his constant encouragement. I would like to express my heartfelt thanks to Principal Dr. V.G. Thackeray, who allowed us to carry out this event. My thanks also goes to Secretary Sri Shivaji Education Society Amravati for sharing the link with the various schools. I thank Dr. G.N. Chaudhary, Dr. Anjali Bodhare and all the department staff who took efforts to organize this event since last 3 months. I would also like to thank all the school teachers for sharing this link of the event to the school students. I thank all the BSc second year students for the efforts towards making the video. Last but not the least, my sincere thanks to all the students for lending their ears. Your presence have made this event a grand success. I request all the students to solve the quiz based on the demonstration and receive your e-certificate. Thank you and God bless you. Today, I would like to carry a message. A hibiscus flower every fortnight blooms on it. Big, bright and tender. Through the day, it smiles with the sun and dances with the wind. But as evening approaches, it starts wilting. The morning after, it withers completely and falls. The flower comes to life only for a day, yet it does so in full splendor. What if we too lived our life, however short, but to its fullest? The stream does not make any effort to make anyone happy, but its very presence makes the grass grow greener. The flowers blossom and the birds chirp with joy. just like the little stream. You can be a source of joy, happiness and positive energy wherever you go, without making any effort whatsoever. You can do this by getting in touch with yourself, by understanding yourself, valuing yourself, forgiving yourself, and giving yourself the much needed love.